The truth is, rap group 36 Mafia is considered one of hip-hop's legendary rap groups. They rose to fame in the 90s and early 2000s, dropping countless hits, eventually growing a cult following. The legendary group is even credited for birthing one of the darkest forms of hip-hop, horrorcore rap. What many people don't know is what the group had to do to make it in the industry, who to this day, they still serve. Join me in this episode as we uncover the dark truth about 36 Mafia. The rap group 36 Mafia was created by DJ Paul and Lord Infamous, and it was originally made up of three members, DJ Paul, Lord Infamous, and Juicy J, but later they would add three more members, Crunchy Black, Gangsta Boo, and Koopsta. One of the original group's project was called Portrait of a Serial Killer, and is credited with birthing the horrorcore genre in hip-hop. Horrorcore rap, for those who don't know, is a subgenre of hip-hop that consists of dark energy beats and horrifying lyrics that are packed with demonic energy. In 1993, some of the members of the group would release one of their most notable projects, Come With Me to Hell, before 36 Mafia would officially be formed. The project contained rough drafts of many hit songs, like Tear the Club Up, that would eventually become big hits later in the group's career. The group started calling themselves 36 Mafia after Lord Infamous will refer to his crew as the 36 Mafia in one of his songs. The group felt like the name fit perfectly with the vibe of the group and what they represented. 36 Mafia got much of their early inspiration from another rap group that spread a very destructive agenda in hip-hop as well, NWA. I believe NWA played an important role in the selling out of hip-hop. If you guys would like to see a full video on NWA, comment NWA. If 700 people comment NWA, I'll make sure I make a video on them. In 1987, 36 Mafia would start their own record label after falling out with their previous label. They called the label Hypnotized Minds, and it would be where they would release their hit songs as 36 Mafia. In 1997, the group would sign a record deal with Sony Music and began to work on their second studio album, World Domination, with their hit song Tear the Club Up being the lead single. This album would blow up and take the group to new heights not yet reached at the time. The album would eventually go gold, selling over 800,000 records, establishing the group's presence in the hip-hop scene. This is what you may already know about 36 Mafia, but the truth is much more sinister than this. Many people probably supported 36 Mafia without knowing that the 36 Mafia openly worshipped the devil. Many people didn't even realize the group's name in itself was an honor to Lucifer. We all know what 36 stands for, 666, and it's the mark of the beast, and it was probably incorporated in the rap group's name. The group even introduced horrorcore rap, which is literally open satanic music. Rappers like ICP make horrorcore rap and are one of the most popular groups within it. We can see since the beginning of 36 Mafia's career what their intentions were, to guide their fans to hell with their demonic music, as they blatantly named one of their early projects, Come With Me to Hell. Unlike in our current world, back in the 90s and early 2000s, the satanic symbolism was much more hidden, as the Masons just wanted to subliminally expose listeners to the agenda. Now that the Masons have managed to manipulate most of the world's population into accepting satanic morals, the agenda is much more open and visible for the world to see. Back when 36 Mafia were big, the Masons used them like many other acts at the time to hide the agenda within their music and secretly push it to their fans. This can be seen in one of their biggest songs known by practically every hip-hop fan, Stay Fly. What many people don't know is that the hit song that the world knows and loves has a demonic hidden message in the chorus that I'm certain many of you never caught when the song was released. I myself never knew what I was listening to as a child, as I blindly sang along to the hook with my older brother. In the hook of the song, if you listen closely, you can hear what seems to be a choir of women singing, "You are God, you are King, Lucifer." This blew my mind, as this was a song that I still remembered as an adult many years later. When I started researching this group, I realized as a child I was pretty blind to the evil and was manipulated into looking up to these demonic rappers. The group has plenty of songs where they openly admit to serving Lucifer's agenda. In their song Favorite Scary Movie, Lord Infamous openly admits to performing satanic rituals and participating in voodoo. As he raps, demons dance to the chants of the rituals, black magic, wicked voodoo. In another song by members of the group called Front Page, we can hear some of the members proudly announce their alliance with Satan. The artist Gangsta Boo admits to being Satan's daughter, as she raps, "Gangsta Boo, the devil's daughter, quick to make your lemons fall," openly admitting who she is serving and what she has chosen to represent. In the same song, Koopsta makes a lot of demonic claims, but the one that stuck out the most was when he rapped, "Strange, I'm in the Holy Bible. They can't escape, for no soul is in me. Come on now, burn with me. Satan is my witness." Clearly indicating that he sold his soul to the devil. He knew he was going to hell and was now on a mission to guide his fans to the same fate as him, openly admitting that their music was used to serve Lucifer's agenda. In the same song, Lord Infamous raps, "Satanic 666, Satan himself gave me a gun," clearly admitting to once again being in alliance with Lucifer. offer. What's crazy to me is that most of the group's fans had no idea who they truly served and what they were even rapping along to. In another 3-6 Mafia song by the name of Mystic Styles, Lord Infamous once again admits to 3-6 Mafia being a product of Lucifer himself. As he raps, "Feel the wrath of the devil's nation, 3-6 Mafia, creation of Satan." In the same song, Gangsta Boo again admits to being Satan's daughter. As she raps, "The moon is full, all I see is 666, 3-6 Mafia, the devil's daughter." In this same song, DJ Paul also admits to being a Satan worshiper. We can clearly see they hid their lines within the lyrics of their music so their fans could blindly take it in. 3-6 Mafia knew what their purpose was, to hypnotize their fans to follow the Masonic agenda. That's why they created their own record label and called it Hypnotize Music. They knew what their task was and how they were going to continue to have famous success in the industry. One of the members, Crunchy Black, did an interview with Vlad TV where he openly admits to meeting the devil. In the interview, Crunchy admits to 3-6 Mafia's association with Lucifer. He openly speaks about how he made a deal with Lucifer, but claims he still has his soul, as he claims he outsmarted the devil and never sold his soul to him. It seems at one point he wanted to speak on DJ Paul, but stopped himself from doing so. To me, it's clear that the members of the group chose to align themselves with the devil. Crunchy speaks on when he met the devil and how the devil approached him, clearly admitting to the group being used by Lucifer to further the agenda, as he even admits to the group leading fans to follow Lucifer. Even though Crunchy Black denies selling his soul, I find it hard to believe. As in the song I Thought You Knew, he admits to being a demon child and again admitting to his connections to Lucifer. Some people online have questioned what led to Lord Infamous suddenly passing away of a heart attack in his sleep at the young age of 40. Since then, many have speculated if it had anything to do with 3-6 Mafia worshipping the devil. To me, I wouldn't be surprised, as they openly serve Lucifer and admitting to working for him. As we have seen many times before with many of these artists, the devil is no one to make a deal with, as you never know when he might turn on you. It's clear to me that 3-6 Mafia played an important part in furthering the Masonic agenda. They slowly, in their own words, hypnotized their fans and manipulated them to follow a destructive path that would lead them to a burning end. Many of their fans had no clue what music the group truly made. As I always say, we must remember what these artists have agreed to do in order to live out their dreams. We must not allow them to manipulate us and guide us on a destructive path. We must remember to protect our souls and help those who can't see the truth find the truth. Thank you for watching this episode of The Truth Is. If you would like to further support the channel, join me on Patreon, the link would be in the description. If you join before the 28th of this month, you could be entered to this month's monthly raffle, where you can win a shirt, a cash prize, and even pick a video topic. Also, please leave a comment below on your thoughts on this video and on any future topics you would like to see me cover on my channel. If you like this video, please hit the like button, as this helps other people find these videos. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe and hit the bell so you can be notified of future videos. Please follow me on Instagram at TheTruthIs01 and on TikTok at TheTruthIs. I would gladly appreciate it. Thank you. Goodbye.